different is the Edmonton Eskimos defense without J.C. Sherritt?
You know, they're still a good defense. I think they're, you know, they're led by their front, of course. They have one of the best fronts in the league. But, you know, I think the Corinne guy they have in behind Sherritt, he's a pretty solid player. He's still getting used to the game, but, you know, Sherritt, he was a beast. Not only was he, you know, a great player, he was smart. And, you know, they're going to miss him out there. So, you know, I hate to see good players injured, but I'm glad we don't have to deal with them.
You mentioned Sherritt's out. I think Grimes is out, and I think Thompson didn't practice this week. Some of the Edmonton media are suggesting you're going to have a field day this week. What are your thoughts about that expectation?
Well, I hope so. I mean, you know, I'm pretty sure that whoever they put in is probably a good player. But, you know, when you're dealing with young guys in their secondary, you want to take advantage of it. So, you know, hopefully, you know, we can get the running game going. Coach puts me in a good position to take advantage of some of their mishaps on defense.
When they're 1-6, you just want to jump on them immediately, don't you?
No doubt about it. I mean, you want them, you know, they've been losing a couple games here lately. So you want them to have that doubt creep back in. So we definitely want to come out, you know, and also we've been getting off to some slow starts the past couple weeks. So, you know, this is a team we really want to jump on the road. We're going to have some of our fans out there, and, you know, we want to make it loud for them.
Edmonton has one of the weakest defenses in the league. What do they do good that you guys need to be aware of?
Well, first of all, I think it starts up front. I mean, they have a great front four. Even the guys they sub in are pretty good. So, you know, I think the main thing this week is just control their front, make sure I can stay off my back, stay upright, and get the running game going. When we were out there the first time, we started off, you know, moving the ball well. Sheets had an early touchdown, got Taj involved early, and I kind of threw them off balance. So we just want to make sure we control their front.
Are they as bad as their record shows?
Not at all. I mean, you know, if you look at the past couple games they've played, it's all come down to the wire. They've had a chance to win. They even had a chance to win last week against, you know, the defending Grey Cup champ. So, you know, I know their coach is telling them that, you know, they have a shot to come out and do some good things against us. So we want to jump on them early and give them, you know, put that doubt in their mind right away.
Do you think you got enough chemistry working with whoever takes over bag spot at wideout this week?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's, you know, we've been here 9 weeks now, and, you know, everybody that, you know, has pretty much gotten an opportunity to work with the first team offense. So I think we'll be fine.
Guys like a Riley as well is a bigger guy moving him maybe possibly to wide out. Have you seen any improvement from him in the last few weeks?
No doubt about it. I think he's getting a lot more comfortable. With him going against our defense each and every day, that'll definitely get you better as a player. So he's getting a lot more comfortable. He's getting better, and you know, we're looking forward to having him out there.
Do you see any maturation process at all in Mike Riley? He seems to be finding his groove.
I mean, of course, anytime you can have some success and you start off struggling, whenever you start playing well, of course you you know, you show signs of improvement. So, you know, our defense is a different beast, and you know, what you did against other teams probably won't happen against our defense. So, you know, I'm looking forward to our defense coming out and being the strong unit that they are.
500 yards last game with the yard goals. How important is for guys like you to get some pressure on Riley?
I mean, I think it's very important. It's one of those fundamentals of the game that go all together. Us on the front end, help those guys on the back end, and it seems like he's been coming along since the beginning of the season, or what we've seen from the first time we've seen him to now. So I think it's very important.
What about a 6-1 team? Your opponent's 1-6. How do you sort of get up for that kind of game? And a lot of people think you sort of played out of the competition. You got a 6-1 versus 1-6. How does a player sort of get up for that?
I mean, you got to stay up. This is CFL. Any team can win any week. You know what I mean? It's been shown time again, time out. Like, I think it was BC the year before, 0-5, and wound up going to the Grey Cup the year that they won it. So it's something that you can't look at, definitely, with the offense coming along the way it is, and those guys still fighting. People fighting for jobs, fighting for a win, fighting for everything. So you still got to take it very serious.
Success, or I guess recently, over the years, there hasn't been a lot of success in Commonwealth Stadium for the Riders. Is that something players talk about or think about when you head into an enemy territory and you know they historically haven't done great things there?
Oh, most definitely. It's something that you keep in the back of your mind that you haven't won there, I mean, as often as you would like to win when you go. So, I mean, it's definitely something I think that plays in the back of the players' minds. Then we got a couple players that used to play there. So, I think they'll feed into that for sure.